Let's insert the windows of the ground floor. The behavior of windows is identical to that of doors. So we can run the windows command. We can choose one window style, casement for example, and the insert options. We're going to show the ground floor wireframe display mode, and we'll choose here the profile dimensions. We'll select other in order to measure the width in place, adjust like a round number, and define, for example, a height of 1 meter and elevation of 1 meter too. We can select the horizontal alignment to left in order to snap to the endpoint of this wall, and repeat the same operation with the other windows. We can just copy this window from one point to another, and later on select them and change their dimensions from the Windows Properties panel. We will repeat the same operation for this window over here. And for this other window, we will just run the mirror command. Also, we don't want to show these windows aperture in 2D, so we will select them, and from the Properties panel, set the max aperture to 0. Now, let's insert the windows in this northern facade of the ground floor. But first, I will draw some auxiliary lines that I will use to measure the width of these windows. So basically, I need a line that goes from this point to the middle point of this wall, and now I can just insert a window. So I run the window command, I select any style, the profile would be set to other, so I can measure the width according to the distance of the segment that goes from this point to the middle point of it, and finally we'll set the horizontal alignment to left and max aperture to 0. So I can now insert the windows, define the opening side by clicking in one side of the wall, and I can just select this window, copy it next to the other one. For the other two in the opposite side of the wall, I will use the mirror command, and for this middle one, I will just insert a new window. So I select this point, the width would be this distance, and finally define the opening side. If the window has detected the wrong wall, we may need to change the horizontal alignment. So we will just select right and move it in our position so it detects the proper wall, and finally move it from this point to this point. There we go. Now we can change the height of these 5 windows so they are as high as the wall from the front viewport. Make sure the project OSNAP is on, and from the window properties panel we're going to change the height by measuring it from here. Also, we can see that there is this piece of wall that goes through the window. In order to shorten it, we're going to work from the ground floor. We will enable the control points of this wall and click on this extension arrow to move it from this point to this point. We can see that the wall still goes through the windows, so finally we will select these two walls and we will change its intersection type. So we will go to this wall join icon and we will set the intersection type to none.